नमस्कार, खुश रहो बिटिया। मायसेल्फ जेवियन डॉक्टर प्रमिला काजला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजियोलॉजी एंड बायोकेमिस्ट्री, फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडेज अवर टॉपिक इज सर्कुलेटरी शॉक। Shock is a general term that refers to the depression or suppression of body functions produced by any disorder. Circulatory shock refers to shock developed by inadequate blood flow throughout the body. It is a life-threatening condition and it may result in death if the affected person is not treated immediately. Following are the manifestations of circulatory shock. First one is, whenever cardiac output is decreased, arterial blood pressure drop down. Second one, low blood pressure produce reflex tachycardia and reflex vasoconstriction. Third one, tachycardia decreases the diastolic period. So the filling of heart reduces, leading to decrease in stroke volume and systolic pressure. This decreases the pulse pressure below 20 mmHg. Pulse also become feeble. Stagnant hypoxia develop because of decreased velocity of blood flow. After that, skin become pale, cold due to vasoconstriction. And along with hypoxia, cyanosis also develop in many parts of body, particularly earlobe and fingertips. After that, GFR and urinary output are reduced due to falling blood pressure and constriction of renal blood vessels. Metabolic activities of myocardium are accelerated because of reduced blood flow and increased heart rate. A large amount of lactic acid is produced, resulting in acidosis. Acidosis decreases myocardial efficiency and pumping action of heart, leading to further reduction in cardiac output. So the blood flow to vital organ is severely affected. Lack of blood flow to brain tissue produces ischemia, resulting in fainting and irreparable damage of brain tissue. Finally, the damage of brain tissue and cardiac arrest kill the victim. Stages of circulatory shock. Circulatory shock occurs in three stages. First stage or compensatory stage, second stage or progressive stage, third stage or irreversible stage. First stage is also called non-progressive stage, when blood losses is less than 10% of total volume, the blood pressure decreases only moderately, and the regulatory mechanism in the body operates successfully to re-establish normal blood pressure and normal blood flow throughout the body. Thus, the stroke becomes non-progressive and the patient recover. Regulatory mechanism involve negative feedback control. Regulatory mechanism are baroreceptor mechanism, renal mechanism, ADS mechanism. So in this diagram we can see acute loss of blood less than 10% of total blood. So after that, decreased venous return, decreased cardiac output, decreased blood pressure, and compensatory mechanism run out, that baroreceptor mechanism. After baroreceptor mechanism activated, tachycardia, increased cardiac output and increased blood pressure. Vasoconstriction also cause increased blood pressure. In compensatory mechanism, renal mechanism activated. In renin secretion, which causes angiotensin second. Convert angiotensin first to angiotensin second, and secretion of aldosterone. And aldosterone cause vasoconstriction. Angiotensin second cause vasoconstriction, and after that increase blood pressure. In compensatory mechanism, ADH also play role. ADH mechanism, water and sodium retention, increase blood volume, and after increasing blood volume, कार्डियक आउटपुट इंक्रीज एंड इट लीड्स टू इंक्रीज ब्लड प्रेशर. सेकेंड स्टेज ऑफ प्रोग्रेसिव स्टेज. Second stage is also called decompensatory stage. When the stroke is reversed, positive feedback system develops so that regulatory mechanism become inadequate to compensate and the stroke enter progressive stage. With immediate and appropriate treatment, this stage of stroke can be reversed. During this stage, the blood pressure falls to a low level, which is not adequate to maintain the blood flow to cardiac muscle. So the myocardium start deteriorating because of lack of nutrition and oxygen. Toxic substance released from tissue also suppress the myocardium, particularly the bacterial toxin called endotoxin affect the myocardium severely. Loss of blood flow also causes suppression of vasomotor system and the sympathetic system. This causes further fall in blood pressure due to low pressure. Thrombosis start in small blood vessels like capillaries. Now the capillary permeability increase, allowing passage of fluid from blood vessels into interstitial space. Finally, because of tissue deterioration, severe symptoms start appearing and the stroke progressive to irreversible stage. In this diagram, we can see acute loss to 10% to 15% of blood loss. It leads to severe reduction in venous return. After that, severe reduction in cardiac output also. And it leads to severe decrease in blood pressure. So it causes severe MI, myocardial ischemia, release of toxin from damaged cardiac tissue, further deterioration in cardiac functions. And severe decrease in blood pressure also lead to suppression of vasomotor center. It is also reduction in cardiac output also suppress vasomotor center, which causes severe vasodilatation, further decrease in blood pressure, thrombosis formation in capillaries, obstruction in capillary blood flow, increased capillary hydrostatic pressure. It lead to increased capillary permeability and fluid diffusion into interstitial fluid, which causes deterioration of other tissues. Third stage of irreversible stage. Third stage is the last stage prior to the collapse. It is also called refractory stage. Irreversible stage lead to death regardless of type of treatment offered to the patient. It is because of brain fails to function due to severe cerebral ischemia. The blood pressure falls drastically. Even the infusion of blood fail to restore blood pressure. Finally, cardiac failure occurred due to decrease in myocardial activity and reduced anterior tone, resulting in death of the affected person. So in this diagram, we can see acute loss of more than 15% of total blood, which can cause decreased coronary blood flow, myocardial ischemia, cardiac failure, after the drastic decrease in cardiac output and drastic fall in blood pressure lead to death. It also causes decreased cerebral blood flow, cerebral ischemia, failure of vasomotor center, which causes generalized vasodilatation and pooling of blood in veins, decreased venous return. It leads to decrease in cardiac output, which causes fall in pressure and at last death. More than 15% blood loss also causes continuous sympathetic discharge, constriction of venules and pre-capillary sphincters, reduced venous blood flow, failure to wash out metabolites, release of vasodilators, dilatation of veins. It causes decreased venous return, which leads to decreased cardiac output. It causes drastic fall in blood pressure and it leads to death. This session is powered by digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.